Hello and welcome to this Getting Started video tutorial. The goal of this session is to set up your Sippy Softswitch for the first time. And by the end of the session, we will be able to make some calls through the Softswitch using a SIP softphone and inspect the call detail records generated by the calls we made. The first step in achieving these goals will be to create a vendor and a vendor gateway. Our Softswitch will send calls to the gateway. We will add destinations and the rates we pay for vendors for those destinations. We will then create a routing group, which allows us to control call routing to our vendors. After we have finished with vendors, we will switch to the customer-facing records. We will create a tariff sheet, a service plan, and an account for our customers. Then we will connect a softphone with the system and make some calls. So let's get started. Log into your new Sippy Softswitch using the URL and credentials that you received in your welcome email. After you log in, you will see the CDR summary screen. On the left-hand side, you will see the menus for navigating all the features of your Softswitch. The first step is to create a new vendor. We do this by navigating to the My Vendors menu section and clicking on the Vendors link. We create a new vendor by clicking the Add button. Let's call it Teletest Vendor. You will see that it has a web login and password. This is an optional login that you can give to your vendors. They can then log into your Softswitch to view CDRs and data that relates only to that vendor. Do not worry, the vendor will not see any records from your switch, only records that relate directly to the calls that you send to that specific vendor. You can set the time zone for this vendor. This dictates what time zone CDRs will be displayed to your vendor, if they log in using their credentials. The balance field will keep track of the balance you hold with your vendor. The balance is not enforced, it is for information only. If this balance goes negative, the switch will still continue to route calls to this vendor. We will set the balance to $200 for this demonstration. Click the Save and Close button to save this new vendor record. The next step is to add a vendor gateway. We do this by clicking Open Connections in the action bar, and then click the Add button. We will call the connection Gateway 1. The destination field either contains the IP address or the host name. This is the address that your switch will send voice calls to. If your vendor supports SIP digest authentication, then you can put the username and password in here. Number translation rules allow you to add prefixes to calls that you send to this vendor. If you want to learn more about number translation rules, please look for the number translation video tutorial on your help portal. We will leave all the other gateway settings as their default settings. The next step after creating a vendor is to create a destination set. Using the navigation menu, look for the routing section and click on the destination sets. Then click on the Add New button to create a new destination set. Give your destination set a name, for example, My Super Destination Set. The next step is to add routes. Click the Open Routes link in the Action column. You can create routes in one of two ways, by adding one at a time using the web interface, or by creating them in bulk using the bulk upload facility. In this video tutorial, we will create a few routes manually. To learn more about managing routes in bulk, please look for the Bulk Destination Set Route Management video in our SippySoft support portal. Let's add a route by clicking the Add button. I'm going to create a route for Vancouver, Canada. The prefix for this destination is 1604. We can control when this route becomes active or when it expires by setting the appropriate activation and expiration date fields. Let's assume that our vendor charges us 2 cents per minute to terminate calls to Vancouver. When we are done, click the Save and Close button. On the next screen, we can see that the new route has been created and the system has correctly identified the route as being in North America and specifically in British Columbia. The next step is to create a routing group. Using the administration menu, look for the routing section and click on Routing Groups. Routing groups tie together our vendor gateways and destination sets, and allows us to set policies on how we choose to route calls to our vendors. Let's give this routing group a name. You can choose many different routing policies. For this demonstration, we will use the default, which is prefix length. Next, we need to add a routing entry. We'll use the vendor gateway and destination set that we already created. Next, we click Save and Close to save the routing group. Now we have created a vendor and a gateway, a destination set, and a routing group. To learn more about routing groups, look for our advanced routing group video on our support portal. Now we will change focus and start configuring the system for our clients. First, we will create a tariff sheet. This is similar to the destination set routes we created earlier, except it controls the routes and rates that we offer and charge to our clients. In the menu, look for the tariff and currency section and click on tariffs. To create a new tariff, click the add new button. Let's call our new tariff awesome tariff. Then click save and close. Next, we need to add rates for this tariff. Click the open rates link in the action column for our newly created tariff. Similar to how we created a destination route, we will add a tariff rate for Vancouver, Canada. The prefix is 1604. To create this prefix, click the add button. Type 1604 into the prefix field and add the price that you will charge your clients for this route. We will leave the billing parameters as standard. The standard billing pattern is 1-1, which means per second billing. Click save and close to save our new tariff rate. Now that we have created a tariff, we need to create a service plan for our customers. To create a new service plan, go to the tariff and currencies menu section and click on the service plans, then click the add new button. We need to give our service plan a name. Let's call it Holiday Call Saver Plan. We need to choose a tariff that will be used for this service plan. Let's choose the one we already created. We can also choose the billing cycle, which controls how regularly the customer will be billed. Let's choose the weekly billing cycle and set the customer's bill date to on assignments. This means that the customer's weekly billing cycle will happen when the customer was created or assigned to the service plan. We will configure this plan to be prepaid. It's possible to create service charges that will be charged to the customer plan on every billing cycle and add connection fees for their inbound DIDs. For this tutorial, we will continue to keep things simple. To save the service plan, click save and close. Now that we have service plan and tariff established, we can finally create an account. In the menu, look for the My Customer section and click on Accounts. This screen allows you to view and filter your existing accounts, export your account list, add or generate accounts, and also manage accounts in bulk using the bulk upload feature. To create a single account manually, click the Add button. We will create a new account with the username 100 and a password 123 wibble wobble. We need to select the routing group that applies to this customer and a service plan. We will use the routing group and service plan that we created earlier in this video. We will leave all the other parameters as default and click save and close. We can now see our new account has been created. If you look to the left, you can see on the account has been flagged. If we place our cursor over the flag, we can see the reason. The reason stated is available credit is zero. So let's add some funds to this account. Click on the account name, go down to the maintenance section and select add funds action. We will add $5 of credit to this account for testing purposes. Now it is time to test the newly created account and that the system configuration is functioning correctly. In this tutorial, we will use a soft phone called Xlite from a company named Counterpath. This is a freely available soft phone which runs on Windows and Mac OS X. It is very easy to use and useful for testing your soft switch. The download page for the free version is a little hard to find, as it is buried deep inside the Counterpath website. I'll search Google for Xlite download and navigate to their download section for Xlite. After you've downloaded and installed the soft phone, you'll need to configure it to register to our soft switch using the account we created earlier. Go to Preferences, Account, and click Add. The account name we created earlier had a user ID of 100, and the domain name should contain the IP address of your switch. This is the same IP address you will see in your web browser address bar. The password we said earlier was 123 wibble wobble. The rest of the settings can be left blank. After we click save, we can see that the status of the soft phone has turned green. We can also expect an automated call from our soft switch to the soft phone, which will help us to confirm that the account is working correctly.
Welcome. If you hear this automated message, your phone has been configured properly and you can start making calls. Thank you.
If we look at the account screen in our switch, we will also see that the status of this account is now green because it has registered successfully. I will call a Vancouver number using the Xlite soft phone. The phone is ringing. And the other end answered the call. I will now hang up using the Xlite soft phone. The call is completed successfully. Let's find the call detail records that this call has generated. First, we will look at the CDRs for the account. Look for the My Customer section and click on the Call Records CDRs link. This screen allows you to view and filter CDRs in your system. By default, it will display calls that have been made within the past hour. Here you will see the CDRs for the call we just made, to the 604 number. You can see the accounts that the call originated from, the number dialed, the duration of the call, and the billed duration of the call. If you're trying to track down CDRs for calls that are not completing, then you can adjust the CDRs filter by selecting all or just errors. Next, we will review the vendor CDRs that have been generated by our test call. In the menu bar, look for the My Vendor section and click on Call Records, CDRs. The vendor CDR screen should look familiar. It has the same basic features as the customer-facing CDRs screen. We can see the time, duration, origin, and destination of this call. We can also see the gateway and vendor that this call was terminated through. Let's make a call to a destination that we do not have routes set up for. Remember, we have only added a route for 1604, which is Vancouver, Canada. Let's call a New York phone number, such as 1212-514-7472. As you can see in the cell phone, it says, call failed to connect. Let's look for the CDRs in the switch to see what happened. We will go back to the customer call records. As you can see, the call attempt to New York shows up here, but it is flagged with a red exclamation mark. If we place our mouse cursor over the exclamation mark, it'll show us the message, no rate found in tariff. We got this error because there is no route for 1212 in our tariff sheet or our destination sets. There is a useful tool in the switch called test dial plan, which makes testing tariffs, routes, routing groups a lot easier. This tool allows you to simulate calls through our system and see what tariffs and routes get returned. Look for the routing section in the system menu and click test dial plan. First, we need to select an account that we will use for the basis of this test. We will select the 100 account we created earlier. We will simulate a call to a Vancouver phone number. Click the update button to see the results. We've already made a test call to Vancouver, Canada, so we can expect the routing to be well formed. The results here show us the tariff prefix that was matched, the routing group that has been used, the price the customer will be charged for the call based on the tariff. Below this, it will show the vendor gateways. In this scenario, we only have one gateway configured, so there is only one possible route returned. In the destination row, it shows the name of the vendor and gateway, destination set, the prefix route, and the estimated cost for this call. Let's try to call that New York number again. You can see that the test dial plan tool produced the error, no rate found, and there is no tariff. This is because the destination does not exist in our tariff. Let's add this tariff. Go to the tariff we created earlier, click Open Rates, and click the Add button. Type the prefix 1212 and set the rate to 3 cents per minute, then click Save and Close. Then let's switch back to our Test Dial Plan browser tab and see what happens this time. Now you can see that it has matched a tariff and a routing group, but there are no gateways returned. That's because there are no vendor routes in our destination set for the prefix 1212. Let's quickly add the prefix to our destination set. And then we will click Update again. There, we can now see that a well-formed set of routes was generated. Now we have covered the fundamentals of configuring a Sippy Softswitch for the first time. You can view system performance graphs by navigating to System Management section of the Softswitch and clicking the Monitoring link. Here you can see graphs of active calls, calls per second, the amount of time the system takes to set up a call, and the network throughput on your switch. The system we are looking at here is a test system, so the graphs don't really tell us much. But when you start managing large volumes of traffic, these graphs become very useful. I dare say they are even exciting. You can also run various reports from the system. For instance, you can track vendor ASR and ACD stats. If you're having interconnection problems with vendors and you need to inspect low-level VoIP protocol messaging, you can get a network traffic dump. Navigate to the System Management section of the menu and click Tools, and then click IP Traffic Dump. From here, you can configure the system to capture raw network traffic, which will be sent to you as a link in an email. You can then view and analyze the PCAP file using tools such as Wireshark. This concludes our Sippy Softswitch introduction. For further documentation, video tutorials, solutions, and feature request forms, you should use our support portal at support.sippysoft.com. From this portal, you can create new and review historic support tickets, search solutions and documentation, read our user forums, and post feature requests. To summarize what we covered in this video tutorial, we created a vendor and vendor connection, destination sets, and routing groups to control how calls get routed. We created a tariff sheet, a service plan, a new account for testing. We configured a SIP soft phone using the free Counterpath X-Lights product, which we used to make some test calls. We analyzed the call detail records that were generated from our test calls, and we also explored the test dial plan tool to simulate how calls through to our system will be treated. We briefly reviewed monitoring tools, reporting, and the IP traffic dump tool. Thank you for choosing us as your trusted VoIP Softswitch vendor. Your business and feedback is very important to us. You can contact our 24/7 support team via our support portal or by emailing support@sippysoft.com. Thank you.